Hello everybody, welcome and thank you as always for watching. Today we're going to have a go at a song again to consolidate the one I did last time about starting to play with a pick. The song that we're going to have a do at is called Hysteria by Def Leppard, and the reason I've chosen it is because it's a very regular 8 beats in a bar. And it's just personally one that I find easier to play with a pick to get the regular speed of the strumming. Of course, if you prefer to play this with your fingerstyle, then please do. Before we actually get started on the song, I think a real good tip would be if you can get yourself the metronome app on your phone. Set it to 107 beats per minute, which is the Def Leppard Hysteria speed, and that will give you an idea of what to practice to. I'll go through the notes here with you now and then take those away and build up your speed on them until you're up to 107, and then once you're at that you'll feel ready to play the song. I'm going to play just a snatch of the song to begin with. Unfortunately, I can't show you the metronome thing myself because my only access to a metronome is on my phone, which is currently recording this. So do please do the metronome thing before you get started on the actual song. It will help you get your rhythm and get your speed, get your regular speed going. In a song like Hysteria, when we're playing 8 beats a minute, the last time out, in the last song we played, Black Star Dancing, we were playing 4 beats in the bar. Now we're playing 8 beats in a bar, so we're effectively doubling. Instead of going 2, 3, 4, going 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. And it does that all the way through, and I just find a pick easier to keep that constant speed going with. I'm just going to play you a quick snatch of the song, and apologies if I'm not sure if it will break into a brief second of Rock of Ages first of all, but this will give us an idea of the rhythm of the song. Speed that the song is going at, and we want to get that regular 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 speed. So the notes of Hysteria are pretty straightforward again, as was with Black Star Dancing. It's in the key of G major, so there is one sharp in play, F sharp, but the bass doesn't play it. It must be up in the top line somewhere again. All the notes in Hysteria are on the plain white keys. Starts off on a D, and he plays 2 lots of 8 on the D. So you need to count yourself 2 lots of 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Then another 16 on G, 3rd fret, 1st string, E string. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Then 8 on the open E, bottom string. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Another 8 on the G again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And then another 16 back on the D on the 2nd string. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And that, just that little riff, gets you right the way through the verse, and then it comes up to a little section that we could call the bridge, the bit where he sings I've got a no tonight. Just changes a little bit there, and it gets your counting needs to get a bit more complicated and involved just temporarily, so do bear with me on this part. We do 16 D's. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And then he goes to a C. So same string, 2nd string, but 3rd fret this time. And he plays 12. Plays the first 8, And then the first four of the second eight are all on C. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4. And then he finishes the final four off back on D again. 1, 2, 3, 4. Then he plays 12 down on B, second fret of the second string. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4. And then back up to D again for the final four. 1, 2, 3, 4. And then he goes back to C, and he does, this time he does 14 beats. So he does the whole eight, and then another six. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. The last two to finish that eight off, he plays on B, and then back on D again. Bit of a mess that, isn't it? So all in all, we're doing 16 Ds. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Might need to work through that one a few times to just to get the rhythm and the where the changes are. And then we're into the chorus, and all he does on the chorus is he's playing an open E, the eight, and then he's playing C, the eight, and D, the 16. And you've just a little thing to be careful of there, because you're playing an open string on your bottom E. And if you just go onto the C without muting your E will be ringing over it. So you just need to be quite careful about muting the E string at the same time as transferring onto your C. It just takes a little bit of work that. There's a few ways you can do it. You could play E's, sit your hand on the top string and get onto the C. Or the way I prefer to do it is to be playing the E, and then when I put my index finger onto C, I press the second string down, but I'm also holding the first string down as well. So although I'm not playing the first string, I killed the note that was ringing on it as well as starting to play the second one. So that would sound like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Held both strings down there, but I'm only playing the second one. You could also damp it with your little finger. Dexterous that you need to be damping it with your little one and holding the third fret of the second string down at the same time, so that it's you want the continuous rhythm of the eight notes. My preferred way is just to hold both the third frets of the first and second string down at the same time and just play string two. And then the 16 on D. Finish, and that gets us through the chorus. Then we do it all again, exactly the same thing again through verse 2, the bridge, the chorus again, and then finally it does a lovely little bit in the guitar solo. First of all, he counts two blank bars, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, and on the fourth beat you hit a harsh A, fifth fret. Then you count another blank four and do it again. And then we're into the guitar solo. And that is, starts on, it changes key here, goes to D major. And it starts on an A. C sharp for two beats only. So we're playing 16 on the A, 14 on the D, and the final two on C sharp, the fourth fret. So we do a little triangle round fifth fret, fourth, round there, just to play 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 2, 2. Does that twice. And then he's back to the bridge part again of the. And then back to the chorus again. And that's the whole song, basically. It fades out just playing D's and G's after that. And if you can write all of that down as you work through this, just split it into those three or four sections again, like we did with Black Star Dancing. And then once you can do those, you're ready to play the song, basically. So I'll try and give the song a go for you. I won't finish it off because once it gets past the guitar solo, it's like I say, it just repeats to the end. We've done it all by then. So I'll just play it up through the guitar solo and then see how that goes. So here comes.
Try to
chorus, and then it just fades out on D's and G's after that. So that's Hysteria, folks, basically. I do hope you'll have a go. Try it with your pick if that is the way you want to go, and if you prefer to stick to finger strumming, then please do that as well. But above all, of course, as always, enjoy it. Thank you very much for watching, and until next time, do please stay safe out there, and I'll hope to see you all soon. Bye.